This is called crucial. If you look at it carefully, you'll see it's a crook stick. And in order to use a crook stick for, to pull things towards you. Long ago, when there were shepherds and sheep, when a sheep was straying, the shepherd would use it to pull the sheep back. I hope I don't have to use it on any of you young people. Do you understand? Good. In this world, the crucial is the symbol of pastoral office of the bishop. He uses it when he has important things to do. So when I was anointing the oil, you saw it in the hand. He uses it when he has important statements to make. I have an important statement to make now. That is why I have it in the hand. In the archdiocese at the moment, we are going through a little study to look at the responsibilities that we have and the resources that we have to fulfill those responsibilities. Among the resources, clergy and religious. Recent study which we told us that to run this archdiocese well, we need 208 priests. We have 113. In other words, I'm missing 95. Of that 113, 39 are over 75, retired, sick, can't come to her for anything else but that they offer up their sufferings to Almighty God for our archdiocese and that they pray for our archdiocese. That's all they can come to her for. That leaves me about 69 accepted. Of those, we have priests in administration, like myself, the Vicar General. We have priests studying overseas. One of them is our brother here, your co-parishioner of the JC. But we have others. We have others working in other archdioceses, other countries, for one reason or another. We have one or two who are missionaries overseas. The church is a missionary church. Whatever they have, it has to have bishop. So they are one of our priests and religious overseas of bishop. What that means is that of the 62 parishes we have, 12 of them are without priests. What that means is that a lot of our priests have to double up and triple up. So for a seed there that are not too good up for Tura, the old parish priest has granted Sacred Chiquito and a whole set of other places. What that means is that a lot of our young priests and not so young priests have 3-4 jobs and they are almost working. They're killing themselves out. They are in danger of burnout. I have told them not to celebrate one or three masses a weekend, but please do keep up the bishops and the Pope. So some of them say 4 or 5 masses on the weekend. I suffered burnout once. It took me 3 years to recover. I can't allow any priest to suffer burnout, because then the last thing goes to the first. What that means is we need more priests. We celebrated 3 years of independence, and while we glory in the fact that we have colonies anymore, we still depend, where church is concerned, we still depend on priests from India and Africa and Europe to come and do what our own people should be doing. What that means is we need more priests. Now, priests just don't drop from the sky. Vocations have to be nurtured, and that nurturing, and I'm speaking to the adults here, that nurturing comes from the family. If I am a priest today, it's because every night, from the time I can remember myself to the time I left home to go to the seminary, my parents gathered us all around their bed at 7 o'clock in the night to say the family rosary every night. After the rosary, we used to have the trimmings. The trimmings were going to be a prayer for an uncle who was drinking too much, or a dad who was sick, or some cousin who wasn't getting up well, or something. But among the trimmings, there was always a prayer that God would grant a family, a priest, and a nun. God bless my parents with both. But it wouldn't have happened if they had instilled in us, if there wasn't a climate of vocation in our homes. You parents, I am asking you to start praying with your children again for me, please. I know that the distraction of anywhere I was a young fellow, we did not know TV. So it might have never been easier. But if you train your children from young, you get them into the habit. You can set aside 20 minutes in the morning or 20 minutes in the evening to pray with your children. I know some of you pray for vocations, but also you pray that somebody as child will become a priest or not, and not your own. But stop praying for somebody as child and pray that God bless you and your children with vocations. Young people tell me that their parents tell them all kinds of nonsense when they broach the subject of vocation. They tell them they won't be happy if my father is not looking happy, if my father is not looking happy, father Adler kind of older, or if I be not looking happy. It is a fallacy to think that they won't be happy in the priesthood. I look happy and I'm a priest working for you. So want you to stop telling your children nonsense. Don't tell your children that I don't know. God bless you all.